All right, one more time. Maryland, UMass, tips in 5 minutes. Wisconsin, Green Bay, Syracuse, about a minute away. If you're expecting Penn, Florida, that's 20 minutes away from tip. We'll start you out with coverage of Green Bay and Syracuse as we continue on the road in just a moment. Stay with us.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevrolet, O'Doul's, and by Pennzoil Motor Oil.
There are over 3 million miles of roads in America. And if you're on any one of them, Chevrolet will be there. Our genuine customer care program will take care of you with a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty, 24-hour roadside assistance, 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion protection, free courtesy transportation if your car ever needs service, and the largest dealer network in the country. That's genuine customer care. Genuine Chevrolet.
Playing hard can be hard work for your back. So don't get caught without the support you need. Get a Sealy Posturepedic. Unlike other premium coils, Sealy's patented Sense and Respond coils give easily at first for comfort. Then, as weight increases, respond with increasing support. Correct support. And only Sealy has these patented steel beams, not wood. No wonder it's endorsed by so many great athletes. Posturepedic support, only from Sealy.
You've got the winning color!
Make your engine last longer. Change your oil every 3,000 miles and use the newest Pennzoil. Now with a revolutionary Pennstar molecule, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings. Clings in, on, around, and between moving parts to reduce heat, friction, and wear like no other motor oil.
My car's got 295,000 miles on it.
It has 161,000 miles.
314,000.
173,000.
Pennzoil has always stood by me. It's never failed me.
You got the winning color!
Green Bay and Syracuse, and off the court, Nordgaard, who was the leading scorer in their opening victory over California, 24 points, had 9 boards along with it. Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here in Ogden, Utah. We are in the opening minute, no score. The number 12 seed, Fighting Phoenix of Wisconsin, Green Bay, against number 4, the Orangemen of Syracuse.
Phoenix is going to have to do a really good job as far as screening out. They switch really well on defense, but they need to keep the white jerseys out of the lane because Syracuse is very tough on the offensive boards.
The Orangemen 22-6 after their victory in round 1. Wisconsin, Green Bay 27-6. Dick Bennett, their coach, in his 18th year with more than 500 victories. Jim Boeheim in his 18th year.
Syracuse in a zone matchup. They don't have to work as hard defensively in a man-to-man.
Gresham Martinez working outside for the Phoenix. They pass the ball well, but there's a steal by Lawrence Moten. Jackson still looking for the opening points. Otis Hill, that won't drop. Jackson, good follow, and he finally gets the first points of the game.
Great hustle by Jackson getting another offensive board. They, again, Orangemen being very aggressive, using their height, going after the offensive boards.
Syracuse trailed by 3 at halftime to the Rainbows of Hawaii in round 1 and then shot 64.5% in the second half as Jim Boeheim finally got Autry to penetrate better and it turned their offense around. Ludvigsen for 3. Now make it a 2-point shot just inside the line. We're tied at 2.
It's really a smart play by Jim Boeheim coming up in the 2-3 zone because we've seen Green Bay go up against a man-to-man and they make you work harder in that man-to-man because you're constantly moving. Against the zone, they have to make good passes.
Rush with an interception for the Phoenix. Syracuse in their 21st NCAA tournament. They were here 2 years ago, losing in the second round. Last year on probation, had no opportunity to be here. That's Martinez for 3. John Martinez, a senior from Milwaukee, at 13 points, 7 assists against California. Still bothered with a knee injury that saw him miss the first 8 games of the season. You see he's wearing a brace. A pass into Wallace, and the first foul of the game. Looks like LeDuc will pushing on John Wallace.
Eric Lazuca, very good defensive player. You talk about John Martinez. He is the leader of this ball club, Tim. How he goes is how the Phoenix go. Very heady player, very calm out there, very patient.
There is Dick Bennett, his 18th year. Coached in high school for 10 or 11 years, has always been in the small college scene, and says maybe time has passed him by for the big boys, but he loves Green Bay, likes living there, has his family there, and has the respect of his peers around college basketball. A very knowledgeable and accomplished coach. Jim Boeheim, 15 NCAA appearances with his Syracuse Orangemen.
Wisconsin Green Bay substitution.
Green Bay really getting hurt on the inside play. Syracuse attacking, getting inside that lane with good passes, good ball movement, and they're attacking the boards, and that's why they're getting in the free throw line too.
The Duke picks up two quick fouls, and he is a key man, the senior from Burlington, Wisconsin.
Lawrence Moten with one more free throw.
That brings in Logan Vander Velden, number 32, a senior from Valders, Wisconsin. And Moten hits for two, and it's 5-3. Green Bay. They got one free throw for Moten. 5-3. Green Bay on top.
Against this zone, Phoenix has to pass the ball well, split the seams, and try and get in there for a penetration to kick it back out.
Another steal by Moten, anticipating the feed from Martinez. Lawrence Moten. Moten had 29 against Hawaii, as we said. The junior from Washington, D.C. was a wide receiver in high school. In fact, played there with former Syracuse quarterback Marvin Graves.
He said that's the reason he came to Syracuse, because of Marvin Graves.
If Moten wanted to play basketball, he had to kind of convince the basketball recruiters at Syracuse to give him a scholarship in this sport. Driving the basket is Nordgaard, the leading scorer against California in round one. 24 points.
Green Bay is the type of team that does not make a lot of mistakes, and they have to go inside against the Syracuse team.
Moten's try for three off the rim, and a foul call.
Against this zone, Green Bay not passing the ball quite as well. There's a little bit of lazy pass, and Moten was playing high, steps right into it. And it's a good game right now, with Green Bay leading 7-5.
The Gulf of Mexico, where world-class fishermen like Jim come to battle the big boys.
Jim, you got one.
Yeah, hey, this calls for a celebration. How about a cold O'Doul?
Thanks.
Ah, only 70 calories and not alcohol. Because out here, you never know what's biting.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without all the alcohol, think O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
We may not be the first to promise you the sun, the moon, the stars. But we may be the first to actually deliver them. Introducing the new Camaro convertible. What else would you expect from the country that invented rock and roll?
What happened?
Chevy, got a minute, we gotta talk. You're canceled.
How did you get canceled out of a commercial?
You're not getting the ratings, Chevy.
I like this stuff.
Well, keep the bag, Chev. You're a sport, Chev. You look great.
Tough year. Good chip.
Doritos tortilla thins. Everything else is just a chip.
Every day in 34 countries and over 300 cities, Delta Airlines takes off to the world of facts and figures, budgets, and bottom lines. And when the job is done, we bring you back to the world of mommies and daddies, boyfriends, girlfriends, and best friends. Delta Airlines.
He was not the monster that the world made him out to be.
It takes someone like that to believe the Holocaust never happened. 60 Minutes, Sunday.
Cheesehead Band from Wisconsin Green Bay, all pumped up here as their team has scored one major upset already. Number 5, California Golden Bears knocked off in round number 1. It is 7-5, Green Bay here over Syracuse.
Syracuse is a team that likes to play man-to-man defense, but they see how patient Green Bay, Wisconsin can get on their offense, and so they've gone into a zone.
Fresh off the front iron, Vander Velden with the rebound. He misses. And then it's missed by Ludvigsen as a foul is called on Syracuse.
Green Bay is working a little harder offensively against the zone. That time they had some good quick passes and made the zone commit. And they had some wide open shots.
Corkle picks up his second personal. He had one just before our commercial break. Corkle, their top forward off the bench for Syracuse, a senior from Mission Viejo, California. Ludvigsen makes the first of 2. 3 points for him. Jeremy Ludvigsen is a senior from Edgewood, Iowa, 6'9", averaging 8.5 a game, hits 2. 9-5 for the Phoenix of Green Bay. Adrian Autry directing traffic for Syracuse.
Wallace, their inside game, their inside player. He does a good job on the board there. He keeps it alive.
Autry with the miss. Now Wallace on the feed. And turnaround is good. We are 9-7. Green Bay on top.
Wallace having a big game. Also, he had 24 points in that game against Hawaii.
With 12 rebounds, as you mentioned, he's a force inside, and they need him in there today. Autry's alley-oop for Wallace. And 3 Green Bay Phoenix go right to him. Jackson misses, and Gresh rebounds.
Green Bay really helps out on defense. What Syracuse has to do, once they get double or triple team, they have to kick it out quickly to that open player.
Martinez, number 20, the senior guard from Milwaukee. He's the steadying influence outside for the Phoenix, but they are all real steady. That's Dick Bennett's coaching. Martinez hits for 3. Martinez had 13 against California.
Good rotation by Green Bay. They were able to get the ball inside to Nordgaard, and I know that Syracuse is really trying to hold him off because of those 24 points that he had. But if you get a player like John Martinez hitting the outside shot, it's going to open up the middle for them later on.
Lawrence Moten turned around in the lane. Off the back iron, rebounded by McCorkle.
Syracuse doing a good job getting inside the lane.
Martinez got a piece of it, and it came to Vander Velden. Vander Velden driving the baseline. A big block there by Jackson. Lucius Jackson. Wallace. 4 points for him.
Well, Syracuse comes down, turns the ball over, and they make a great play defensively and then capitalize on the break.
Boeheim says about Green Bay, it's a lot like Princeton in its offensive movement. They make you defend the entire 35 seconds, and you'll see that clock go down frequently, down under 10.
He said the big difference with this Green Bay team, though, is that they've got some good athletes. They're very mobile. They play position defense.
Ludvigsen's turnaround, in and out. Good rebound by Vander Velden. All tied up, and it's a scramble for the ball. Syracuse.
Well, both players going down, hustling after the basketball, but a great block right here. Down below, it's just incidental contact right there.
Autry and Ludvigsen diving forward, and the Orangemen come up with the ball.
Syracuse being very patient on their offense.
Phoenix on a nice move by Wallace. John Wallace at 6'7", sophomore from Rochester, New York.
Wallace had 2 options that time. He had a double team and just spun the other way away from it.
Steal again, Moten, and he gets a freebie. 13-12, 5 points for Moten, and Syracuse on top.
Green Bay does not look as sharp in their passing as they did against Cal. They're not taking care of the basketball. Syracuse doing a good job stepping into the passing lanes.
Vander Velden, and Autry rebounds. Autry going the distance. Ludvigsen comes away with it for Green Bay. Adrian Autry had 16 points against Hawaii, a senior from New York City. Nordgaard, he hits for two. Green Bay back in front by one. 4 points for Nordgaard. Dick Bennett has Jeff Zavada up ready to come in. Three-point range. Two Orangemen down in the scramble. They flip it up for Wallace. It's knocked loose by Martinez.
Great hustle by both teams. They're saying it went off of Wallace's head, but the officials call it for Syracuse.
And we have a timeout on the floor. 10:24 to go in the half.
Stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million. Number one, like a rock. I was strong as I could be, like a rock. Nothing ever got to me, like a rock. I was something to see, like a rock.
The most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road.
Like a rock.
Chevy.
Okay, here goes. Abracadabra. No dialing? Like Shazam? Just my voice? Okay, okay. Call home. It works. I knew it would.
Call now for the revolutionary voice-activated phone card. Only from Sprint.
This is the award-winning Goodyear AquaTread with its deep groove aqua channel. And this is the new Eagle AquaTread for performance sedans. A wider performance tire with two aqua channels to sweep water away. Now you get the wet traction of a Goodyear AquaTread and the performance of a Goodyear Eagle. One good turn deserves another. The new Eagle AquaTread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
This week on Dave, Bill Cosby, Diane Sawyer, Neil Diamond, Elle McPherson, and Rosie O'Donnell. This week.
Syracuse staying in it with the inside play of the 6'7 sophomore John Wallace. The Orangemen doing a good job getting the ball inside to him. He's getting double and triple teamed, but he makes a nice move inside. 6 points already in the first half. And one of the reasons he's able to get the ball is that LeDuc, 6'7 senior for the Phoenix, is in foul trouble with two, and he's had to sit the bench, and that kind of hurts Green Bay a little bit.
Syracuse ball, and that knock out of bounds just prior to our timeout. Green Bay by one. Well, it's still outside, nearly poked away by Zavada. 55 is in the lineup now, centered for Green Bay. Forehand.
They're going to call the push-off. Both these teams completely different in the sense of scoring. Syracuse wants to get those points up. Past 84 is what they average. And the Phoenix, on the other hand, they want to keep the score low.
Well, that was a not uncommon picture of Jim Boeheim expressing his feelings to the officials. That most expressive face. 40 to go first half, a one-point lead for the upstart Green Bay Phoenix.
Syracuse really shifting on this zone very well for them. That's why Green Bay's having a little bit of trouble getting the ball inside.
Kowalski in the lineup, a good three-point shooter for Green Bay, number 34. And Martinez mishandled the pass from Vander Velden. Syracuse ball. Four turnovers now for Green Bay, and they're hearing it from Dick Bennett.
They just did not do this against Cal. They took very good care of the basketball, and they're not doing it in this game.
Using Hill for the screen. Off to Jackson. Willis Hill scoring a newly shaved head for round two.
I thought he had hair the other day.
Well, he had a little bit. He's got a lot less today.
Lawrence Moten sifting in as he does, and that's a bad shot for Moten, uncommonly so. Moten, they got poked in the eye as he delivered that ball. Baseline and fired back outside. This is Berlowski. Won't drop for him.
Well, if Green Bay can get their shot off from the outside, they've got guys hitting the boards, but Moten really holding his eye. And what happened on the defense is the defensive player hit up, and it also hit his arm, and that's why the ball was short on that shot. But when you hit up, you have a tendency to go into the guy's eye instead of coming at you with your palms into you.
Martinez and Berlowski outside. Vander Velden feeding inside for Zavala. He puts the ball on the floor. There's a foul called on Jackson.
Nice pass inside. That time Green Bay was able to get the ball to the high post, and the zone collapsed a little bit. Nice little pump fake by Zavala. You see it spread out. You see the middle wide open. Good penetration right there to the high post. Nice pump fake. And even though the shot is blocked by Jackson, Zavada's going to the free throw line. Good play by Green Bay getting the ball inside.
Zavada trying to coax that free throw in. He knew he was short. Yep, Zavada. Transfer from Marquette. Senior from Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
In Stevens Point, that's where Dick Bennett used to coach, where he coached Terry Porter, who's now in the NBA with the Portland Trailblazers.
Of course, Bennett's son, Tony, in the NBA with Charlotte. He played at Green Bay under his dad. Autry, all kinds of green around him. Nice play by Adrian Autry. Tied at 15 with 8:20 to go, first half. Zavada won't go for him.
That's the shot right there that Green Bay has to take advantage of. They are not shooting the ball as well as they did against Cal.
Autry is short.
Good strong play by Hill grabbing it.
Wallace in traffic, pulls his way in and comes up with two. 8 points for John Wallace. The sophomore from Rochester. Shoots at 51% from the floor, and as we mentioned, at 24 in the opening win against Hawaii. There's a block by Jackson on the three-point try by Berlowski. Moten right at the baseline, making the play. 4-point lead for Syracuse, 7 points.
Green Bay did a good job as far as passing the ball that time, but give credit to Lucius Jackson on that block. Lansky's got to do a better job either doing a pump fake or getting the ball off a lot quicker.
Martinez, his shot is blocked by Moten, is coming to the ball very well. But now Martinez alone, and he misses from the free throw line.
The block's obviously really bothering Green Bay right now.
Vanderbilt picks up the foul.
Good play by Green Bay, kicking it back out. Berlowski wide open, but Syracuse all over them with a 19-15 lead over Green Bay.
The women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
A punctual boy, our son.
Punctual all over the world, UPS drivers are the same. Ask their mothers.
He's not rich. He's not handsome, but punctual.
He was even born on time.
They're obsessed with being on time, so UPS now guarantees on-time delivery to hundreds of cities around the world or your money back.
If my son says he will be there, he will be there.
It's a guarantee that not only has our driver's word on it, it has their mother's.
He breaks out in a rush if he's late.
At Geo, we've thought a lot about safety. That's why Geo Prism comes with standard dual airbags and available anti-lock brakes. In addition, it's equipped with a rugged steel safety cage. You see, we not only want to make accidents easier to avoid, we also want to make them easier to walk away from.
Call 1-800-GET-TO-KNOW and get to know Geo Prism with over 100 standard safety features.
New from Pizza Hut, the ultimate pepperoni pizza. With zesty herbs and spices and thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. This is the ultimate pepperoni pizza. But remember, one bite and there's no going back.
For the first time, there's a saw that combines a 12-amp motor, dust collection, and an auto brake. So there's no limit to what you can build. Introducing the Quantum Circular Saw. New from Black & Decker.
Well, as I was saying, I'll bring the cold drafts, and you just bring those beautiful eyes of yours.
Yeah. Could you hold on?
When cold filtered gets cool enough.
Hi. It's your shot.
Ice draft.
I've got to go.
Susan?
It's ice brewed below freezing, then cold filtered. For a smoother, better draft, taste the future. Ice draft. Only from Budweiser.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
It's update time, Jim Nance, Clark Kellogg. We're going to start you off with a look at Wichita. Maryland shooting about 65%. Maryland in red leading UMass 22-19 with about 10 minutes to go first half.
Dwayne Simpkins has scored 8 points for the Terps. He's made two of three-point field goals. I think the key for Maryland is to continue to play from the front and make sure they get good shots every time down. They've got to do a better job, though, rebounding their defensive board.
Beautiful lob pass inside, cuts it to one. Meanwhile, Penn and Florida, Penn in red, and Penn leading 8-6. Almost 4 minutes into that game out at Long Island's Nassau Coliseum.
This is a game where Penn wants to knock down the three-point shot. Jerome Allen, their outstanding junior guard, who just boarded that miss, already has 2 3-point field goals.
The winner of this game will play UConn in the Sweet 16 round down in Miami on Friday. So there's the update. We'll get a little longer look at these games coming up at halftime. But right now, let's send you back out to Wisconsin, Green Bay, and Syracuse with the Orangemen up 6. Back to Tim and Ann.
Thank you, Jim. Adrian Autry has added 2 more for Syracuse. And they lead 21-15 with 6:19 to go in the half. Green Bay ball and double team on Duke, who just came back into the lineup. Remember, he picked up 2 early fouls, and their defense has suffered without him out there. 6 minutes to go. Bennett has him on, and now he takes him out.
Well, the offense is suffering, too, because he can hit the shot, even though he's averaging 4 points, and he does have 4 points already in this game. They need his offense.
Vander Velden comes back in for him.
6 seconds on the shot clock.
Three-point try well off the mark. Autry rebounding and back quickly for Syracuse, trying to beat the Green Bay defense back down the floor, and he picks up an offensive charge on that play.
Well, on practice, we saw the other day that Dick Bennett was telling his team, we're going to work on getting back on defense against Cal. They are not doing it in this game against Syracuse. That's the first time they've been able to do it.
See there that they're playing at Syracuse's pace so far. They like to use more time during their possession. Syracuse, about 15 seconds is about right for them, but Green Bay would like to knock it down to around the 30 mark before they fire the ball.
One of the reasons, too, Tim, is the fact that a lot of teams play this team man-to-man because they look at their size and they think that they can stay up with them. So in a man-to-man, they're very patient on offense. They set a lot of screens, a lot of blocks, they like to call them. There they're not back on defense again, and they find Hill down low underneath. But since they're not able to set screens and open players up, they're having to pass the ball in the zone.
Hill comes up with his first basket. On the transition, Syracuse getting the ball down very quickly, and it's paying off, 23-15. Nordgaard, they need him to get hot. He had 24 against California. He has 6 so far here with 5:12 to go.
Green Bay will stay in a man-to-man. Dick Bennett will not switch into his own.
Sample of Gresh's quick feet there on Autry driving. Gresh is their best defender in terms of quickness.
About this Green Bay team being a lot like Indiana, where they play position defense. They move their feet and get in front of you.
Vander Velden cuts off Jackson. And the foul is called, apparently, on Ludvigsen.
That's what makes Dick Bennett upset, is the silly fouls like that.
His first personal foul.
He's very animated on the side. Sometimes he doesn't realize what he's doing.
Replacing Drush.
First foul on
Ludvigsen. Replacing Lucius Jackson.
Bolowski back in the lineup for Green Bay. Three-point shooting guard with Martinez in the backcourt. Syracuse will inbound it. Five team fouls on Syracuse, four on Green Bay. Ludvigsen pleading his case that it was off the hands of Wallace, but he lost that.
Ludvigsen really doing a good job inside on the post, fronting that time, but he's getting help from his teammates, and that's what Green Bay is so tough on defense. They help each other out.
Autry driving into the lane, throws up a prayer, and it's rebounded by Ludvigsen. 6-point lead for Syracuse. Ludvigsen, his bank goes.
3-19.
6 points for him.
Syracuse looked a little tired. They did not get back on defense that time, and you can see the position defense by Wallace.
Autry driving. And is fouled by Martinez.
We saw Syracuse in the first half against Hawaii. Autry only had 5 points, but he did not penetrate. He came out in the second half and really took control, and Martinez has been doing a pretty good job on Adrian Autry.
3:53 to go in the first half. Syracuse on top.
We're ball players, and we're okay. We're not fat and lazy like Devonis say. In spring, we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball card. They're ball players, or so they say. They'd rather be doing ads for Bengay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ain't the deal to hawk underwear.
We're ball players, and we're okay. Get in shape by opening day. Thanks to these, we'll be ready to play. Oh, ship your butts to Double A. Yeah.
This is the planet Earth. And this is the most popular line of sport utility vehicles on the planet. Chevrolet.
This time around, you can fly without wings. You can reach the heights, soar in the endless night. This time around, you can fall without fear, because everything's possible. This time around.
Favorite team has returned.
Look at the lineup we have coming back. Rick Wild Thing Vaughn. Catcher and team leader Jake Taylor. Veteran third baseman Roger Dorn. Also back is Willie Mays Hayes. And he's out by an eyelash at third. Boy, we never seem to get the close ones.
Major League 2. Rated PG. Starts Wednesday, March 30th at a theater near you.
Experience a new relationship with the news. The CBS Evening News with Dan Rather and Connie Chung, where your world comes together.
Sometimes I hate it. I mean, it's a love-hate thing, but you feel alive. You're filled with anxiety until it's replaced by either great sadness or great elation, and it just comes fast sometimes.
Dick Bennett on coaching, and that was during the Cal game when he was pounding the floor. Looks like he's getting himself into position right now.
Getting ready, has a lot of passion.
Field goal by number 45, Otis Hill.
Hill connects for Syracuse, 25-19.
Syracuse putting on a press coming out of that timeout, and Jim Gray had been over at the Green Bay bench, and Dick Bennett was saying, hey, let's get the ball inbound, even off a rebound, kick it up, and make them get back fast. That's causing problems. We're not getting the ball down quick enough, and we're not getting back on defense quick enough. Also, we're playing their pace. We're taking quick shots. We need to be more patient on offense.
Syracuse creating some problems with the press, but they get it up to Ludvigsen into Vander Velden, and he misses from in the lane all alone. You got to make those.
And that's what Syracuse wants. They want Green Bay. If they can break the press quick, that's fine because they're taking a quick shot. Green Bay is not playing their game by
Green
the fast
Green
press.
Bay personal foul, number 34, Ben Berlowski.
Berlowski picking up the foul for the Phoenix. Jackson in the game at guard, number 12, a sophomore from Milwaukee for the Phoenix. Moten driving on Berlowski and Jackson over the top. It'll be either Berlowski or Jackson with the foul.
That time Syracuse did a good job clearing out the left side for Lawrence Moten. He's very adept with his left hand, and Green Bay did not shift over to help out on the weak side, which they've done in the past.
Jackson picks up the foul. Bennett substituting more freely here than he did against California as he's trying to come up with a combination here to get his team back into their style of game. As Anna said, they've been pushed out of that style by Syracuse.
You see Moten with the black patch on his jersey. That's for his grandfather who passed away this year with a heart attack. He's very close to him.
9 points for Moten. Livingston outside. Now Jackson will set it up. Sophomore guard, Vander Velden. All the way to Berlowski. Vander Velden in the paint area again, and he traveled, sliding that pivot foot, Vander Velden. So twice he's had opportunities in the lane, and he's 0 for 2.
Well, the big scorer for the Phoenix is Jeff Nordgaard, the 6'6 sophomore. They have not been able to get the ball into his hands. He needs to touch it a lot more. He had 20 shots against Cal, 12 of 20. And he's only got 6 points so far.
Autry backing his way in now. Kicks it out for Moten. Moten trying to drive. And he's fouled. Eighth team foul against Green Bay. So it'll be a 1-1.
Syracuse taking advantage not only of their height, but also their quickness. They're getting past Green Bay. And Green Bay has to do a little bit better job of their positioning.
His second personal foul.
Berlowski picked up his second personal foul. Gresh back into the game, along with Chris Westlake, number 10, a junior guard from Rockford, Illinois. Points for Moten. And the guard play, key for Syracuse, and you can see 37 points per game produced by the guards, and Autry and Moten are a potent pair, and they are the experienced players who have been in the tournament before. Syracuse. Ludvigsen. Martinez driving, unimpeded, he hits. 29-21.
Big bucket by John Martinez. Totally in control, nice ball fake. Middle is wide open.
Eight for Martinez. Back to 8 points. Scramble for the loose ball. Jump ball is signaled. Well, now somebody's out of bounds. We've got a little extra curricular activity on the baseline.
Well, Wallace felt that Ludvigsen was on him, but they called the jump ball. You almost could have called travel because Wallace was rolling around there, but that's one of the tough calls in basketball. Nice strip by Gary Gresh, and then the ball goes down on the ground. Wallace is sliding on his back. Jump ball, they call it, and then Wallace, I guess, pushes Ludvigsen off, so it's Syracuse ball out of bounds.
Basket, a push underneath.
Good out-of-bounds play by Syracuse. They stack four on the lane, and Lucius Jackson with his jumping ability taking advantage, going high, and they call the foul before.
His first personal foul.
Gresh picks up his first personal.
That's the 19 foul at the free throw line. Lucius Jackson.
19 fouls against Wisconsin. Jackson in the 1-1. The officials today, Leonard Wirtz from Mount Healthy, Ohio, Andre Patillo from Decatur, Georgia, Robert Barnett from Baltimore, Maryland.
Lucas Jackson had a big game this year against Connecticut. They were down 18 and he hit 6 3-pointers.
Four points for Jackson, a 10-point margin now for Syracuse.
Syracuse getting to the free throw line, getting the ball inside.
Ludvigsen's bounce pass too much for Nordgaard. Eight turnovers now for the Phoenix.
And they only average 13 turnovers a game.
Hill muscles his way for the turnaround. Otis Hill, the freshman from White Plains, New York. And a steal by Moten. That's four for him. Eric Moten just seems to be anticipating. The Green Bay passes perfectly. 33 to 21. Alley-oop for Wallace. Fouled as he took it up.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul, number 33, Jack Nordgaard.
Well, Green Bay shooting at 32% from the field, and most of that trouble early. Syracuse at 46, not bad. The rebounding all in Syracuse's favor. And Wallace with six of those rebounds and now 9 points.
Well, in the last six games also for Green Bay, they have held their opponents to 32.8% from the floor. And Syracuse is doing a good job getting the ball inside to their big players, which means that they are going to score a higher percentage.
35-21, the Orangemen. This is a neutral site here in Ogden, of course, but most of the crowd will be cheering for the underdog, but Syracuse has kept the crowd out of it. Nordgaard's shot is blocked, knocked out of bounds. No, not out of bounds. Syracuse keeps it going.
Well, it looked like they had a wide open shot. Finally got the ball to Nordgaard, but nothing but block.
Hot three for three. Syracuse has had six blocks in this first half. So good anticipation on interceptions and blocks. Nordgaard from the free throw line, and that goes.
A little bit better ball movement by the Phoenix that time, but also they're still taking quick shots, which is what Syracuse wants.
Final minute of the first half. To the 30-second mark we go.
Fitzen did a good job helping out defensively that time, rotating, because it was a high trying to get up on Hill, and Hill just released, which was a nice pass. Take Ben and using his bench a little bit more.
Martinez kicks it out. Nordgaard, he hits for three. And the zeros are up, so a big three for Green Bay. At the buzzer, 37-26, Syracuse on top. Jim Nance and Clark Kellogg will be along with Pennzoil at the half. After these messages, we'll see you a little later back here in Ogden, Utah.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Nike, Warner Brothers Major League 2, and by Loose Fit Dockers.
Today in America, over 11,000 babies will be born. 2.6 million people will go to the movies. 5 million parents will drop their kids off at daycare. 36 million of us will get where we need to go in a Chevrolet. Think about it. 36 million. It's just another day in America. And more people will depend on Chevrolet than anyone else.
Some people think that athletes have it made. But nobody's life is easy. Everyone has problems now and then. Drugs and alcohol won't solve your problems.
If you or someone you know needs help or information concerning drug abuse, call this toll-free number, 1-800-662-HELP. This message provided by the NCAA.
This is CBS.
During March, there's something in the air that makes us all act a little strange. Well, at Summit City Ford, March Madness is in full swing. Hundreds of new Fords are on sale at Factory Invoice. Plus, get factory rebates up to $1,000. Invoices are posted in the showroom. Take out your car, trot, find the invoice. That's your price. Plus, get a factory rebate up to $1,000. There's something in the air, all right. A March Madness sale at Summit City Ford.
Summit City Ford.
Across from Glenbrook Mall on Coliseum Boulevard.
You've been injured. There's so much to do. You don't have the training or experience to properly handle your claim. Now's the time to call in an attorney with experience in handling claims, someone who's willing to work hard for you. We at Blackburn and Green care about you.
A message from Blackburn and Green, attorneys for injured people.
Three games in action, part three of our quadruple header Saturday on the road to Charlotte, North Carolina.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
Tell you, we have three games in action right now. We started today with one, then we went two ways, now three ways. It's kind of fun to try to focus in on all these games at one time,
isn't
it? Yeah,
but at least we're off the highway. We can now sit back and really enjoy the games at about 35 miles an hour instead of 65 like we've been the last couple of days.
That's what it feels like, that speed, that's for sure. We have one game we want to take it to right now. They're nearing halftime, and UMass on a tear. They trailed most of the way. Let's go out there now and pick up the action.
Keith Booth. Shooting the second free throw. The foul was called on Mike Williams, his first. The second one spins out, so Massachusetts has a six-point lead with a minute 45 left. Now they'll go to the other end to shoot the technical against Booth. Booth goes out of the game with four fouls, and that is huge for Maryland. Booth averages better than 10 points per game and six rebounds. And other than Smith, he's one of the few Terrapins who can really muscle his way inside.
Well, Maryland started this game by getting the ball down inside to Booth and also to Joe Smith and dominating the paint. But as the momentum started to change, you saw UMass getting the ball where they wanted to, using the shot-blocking ability of Marcus Camby and Lou Rowe to control the middle. Now they've controlled it on the defensive end and the offensive end.
The winner of this one plays the winner of the Texas-Michigan game coming up next. That'll be in the Sweet 16 in Dallas. It's an eight-point lead for Massachusetts, the largest lead for the Minutemen. They trailed through much of this first half. Baseline jumper wouldn't go, and the Terrapins push it up the floor. Simpkins had his pass deflected, gathered back in, then was clipped by Padilla. Both sides over the limit. We'll have free throws the rest of the half, a minute 23 remaining. Still the Pennzoil at the half. That is the third personal foul on Edgar Padilla. And Dwayne Simpkins goes to the line.
Dwayne Simpkins had a pretty good game against St. Louis. He had 7 points, four rebounds, but 11 assists.
And that's a career high in assists for Simpkins. A little bit surprised that Gary Williams left Booth in the game with those three fouls.
I agree with that because there was still plenty of time left on the clock, a little over 3 minutes, and he was still on the floor. I didn't think that was a very wise decision.
Bright rebounded the miss. Massachusetts by 7. Minute 15 left of the half. Bright had it blocked by Smith. Rowe scores. Lucas stuck a hand into the defend, but Lou Rowe was able to score. 10 points for Rowe.
Lou Rowe is so active around the glass and loose balls. Got great hands.
Johnny Rhodes scores at the other end. And traveling the call against Dana Dingle.
It's a Terrapins now trying to turn up their defensive intensity. And we're going to keep an eye on when they trap. They trap the first time, cut off the passing lanes.
Technical on John Calipari. He didn't like the traveling call against Dingle. Protested a bit too loudly. And now his assistants step in to avoid the second technical and the ejection.
They better step in awfully quickly because Calipari is on the edge of receiving a second tee.
Well, that Al McGuire made a great point on the Purdue-Alabama game earlier today. When one official makes the call, it really should be another official who makes the technical, because the official who made the call might know in his heart or mind if it was a bad call or not, even after he's made it. And in this case, it was Sam Croft who called the travel, and then Eric Harmon who teed up John Calipari. Simpkins made the first. He has 10 points, the lead down to 6, so a chance for Maryland to take some momentum into the locker room at halftime. The lead is 5. They have the ball out of bounds with 51 seconds left in the half.
John Calipari just voicing his opinion about why the charge was not called. The officials thought that he was out of line in his protest. This could be a big turnaround for Maryland if they can get a basket after the technical foul.
It endured a 13-0 run by Massachusetts. Gave the Minutemen the lead. Lucas too strong with a shot. Canby outdueled Smith for the rebound, and UMass can hold for the final shot of the half.
Marcus Canby's doing a tremendous job inside defending. He's blocked a couple of shots, but more importantly than that, he's making Maryland change those shot opportunities.
Guarded by Hip. Hip with a size advantage at 6'8". Williams. Time for Maryland to hoist a shot. They don't have to hurry. Rhodes fires a 3 at the buzzer. Short. And Rowe the rebound.
Harrison scored the last 4 points of the half at a 5-point Minutemen lead. 4 minutes and change to go. First half out in Long Island. Let's go there. James Brown, Billy Packer, Penn in Florida in a tight one.
Florida has taken the lead by 1 with 4:10 left in the first half. Pennsylvania has gone scoreless in the last 4 minutes. And the big man, Dimitri Hill, on the inside for Florida has been doing a nice job, and he continues to do it in the right place at the right time. Again, a vertical leap of 0 inches. He smothered the ball on the floor. Nice block by Anderson. But then again, when you're a Hill size, every place is the right place. That's at the right time.
This is just a great exhibition of defense by Florida.
22-19. Third seeded Gators lead. Allen. Allen's really having to work hard for a shot, Billy.
Yeah, everybody is. There's just no open looks out there.
Brown. With the foul attempt by DeClercq. Strong rebound by Andy Barada. The senior has done a nice job, Andy Barada.
Penn fans wondering, why aren't we scoring? The reason for it is guys are in your face.
Well, Barada is doing just that, as I mentioned, Billy. Nice job by the senior off the bench. Had an ACL injury before the season. Came back to play, injured the knee again, missed several games, but certainly is playing nicely now. First score by the Quakers in over 5 minutes.
And he's the guy that's hit 2 big jumpers since coming off that bench. Played a lot of minutes. I wonder how much longer we'll see him before there's a sub for him.
Doesn't look winded right now. Ah! Rebounded by Kegler for the Quakers.
He's looking at that bench on the side of his eyes.
Coach is ignoring him. Anderson blocked the shot attempt by Moore.
All right, so Penn will go to the line looking for the lead. If that game heats up in the second half, you know we'll be taking you there. 22-21 Gators. The winner of that game will take on UConn down in Miami on Friday night. Thanks for watching Penn's Oil at the Half. Clark Kellogg, Jim Nance from New York. Stay with us on the road to the Final Four.
Penn's Oil at the Half was sponsored by Penn's Oil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
Suppose would create a car with an interior so well thought out. It gives you the confidence to perform maneuvers like this, even while you perform maneuvers like this. The Lexus GS.
Want more cheesesteaks for your cheesy needs? Some gringo cheese thumbs, please. Once you bite, you just can't stop the fun. The cheesy steaks are so yum.
Now more cheesy flavor, the kind of cheese you wanna savor.
So grab yourself some cheesiness. Not the butter pieces of same greasiness. So put a can in your hand and check it out. The cheesy taste will knock you out.
Relive the color and excitement of the 1994 NCAA Final Four by ordering this year's official souvenir program. The 224-page magazine is loaded with team information, NCAA records, past champions, and all the pageantry that surrounds America's number one sporting event. To receive your copy, send $10 to 1994 Final Four Program, 3342 Melrose Avenue Northwest, Roanoke, Virginia, 24017. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. This message provided by the NCAA.
If you're in high school and you want to play sports at an NCAA Division I or II school, you must be certified by the NCAA Initial Eligibility Clearinghouse. Ask your coach or guidance counselor for one of these student release forms, fill it out, and send it to the clearinghouse. Remember, if you're not certified, you can't compete as a freshman in NCAA Division I or II. For more information, call 319-337-1492.
A new breed of cop.
Chris Trapjack.
With a powerful ally.
Fire him or support him.
Or else
I'm going to tip your desk over on you.
Thursdays, get set for Traps.
Well, Green Bay, Wisconsin, here for this tournament, showing their modesty even in their lodging. They are staying at the Flying J Travel Plaza. I can assure you, well, I'm sure it's a very nice motel. It's not five stars in the state of Utah, but that's befitting the team from the Mid-Continent Conference, and they are trailing by 9. We'll be right back.
They say money will buy more in the new millennium. They say luxury will endure in the new millennium. They even say a car that competes with Lexus and Mercedes can be priced from $26,000 when you're not asked to pay for a luxury division and all that overhead. The new $26,000 millennium from Mazda.
March Madness with the official 1994 NCAA Championship video by calling 1-800-747-7999. It's all here, from the excitement of the opening rounds to the drama of the Final Four. That's 1-800-747-7999 to get your official copy of the 1994 NCAA Championship video.
This is CBS.
Hey, Fort Wayne, Poinsett Chrysler Plymouth BMW is in the grip of March Lease Madness. That's right, only Poinsett has the best lease price you can get on every new car and van in stock. And with no money down, no security deposit, Voyager minivans, America's favorite minivan, and incredible $229 a month. Chrysler Concord, roomy and great performance too, only $269 a month. Plymouth Duster, loaded and ready to roll, just $169 a month. Get into Poinsett and experience March Lease Madness today, but hurry, these deals end March 31st. Poinsett Chrysler Plymouth BMW in the 1469 Auto Mall.
Hello.
Ellen, how's the new house?
Oh, it's great.
Don't you just love our new Pella windows?
Pella?
You know, the ones with the built-in muttons.
Muttons?
The bars on the inside.
Inside?
Slim Shade's also inside the glass. How do they do it?
Beats me.
I am so glad Ermshire's suppliers told us about Pella Designer Windows.
Ermshire's?
You know, the Pella Window Store.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm off shopping.
I think I'll do a little window shopping myself.
Tim Ryan Ann Myers here in Ogden, Utah. Syracuse opening the second half with an 11-point lead. Green Bay with the ball. They are in green. Syracuse in white.
Green Bay basically has two shooters in Martinez and Nordgaard. And the zone, the 2-3 zone, which Syracuse hardly plays at all. They play a man-to-man. Smart play by Jim Boeheim coming out. They've got to use the other players, Green Bay, to shoot the ball.
Syracuse shooting at 50% in the first half. That is below the average of 54.7 that Syracuse holds teams to, but you can see they are cold shooting, 37% on that first half, very costly.
Nice pass.
Wallace, he was in force during the first half, 12 points now for John Wallace. Six rebounds in addition. Now for a report on what happened at halftime, let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, Jimmy, thank you very much. Well, Dick Bennett was all over his team. He said, you guys are a step slow, you're not alert. He came out and he told me, maybe we're just a little bit intimidated today. He wants his team to take some better shots, be more patient, work the clock down. Now, on the other end, Jim Boeheim was angry with his team. He feels they should have put them away in the first half. Jimmy?
Well, they didn't put them away as Moten had 11. Nordgaard had 11 points in the first half for Green Bay to equal that of Lawrence Smoke of Syracuse, and it's 39-26 just underway here in the second half in Ogden, Utah.
A lot of where the intimidation comes from defensively for Syracuse is the fact when Green Bay is going in on the offensive, they're intimidated by the shot blocking. There were six block shots in that first half. They didn't lane. They've got to try and create fouls when they go up in the air rather than trying to make the shot, put themselves on the free throw line, because Syracuse is the type of team they like to jump. Give them a little ball fake, they're going to go up in the air, go by them, or if you're going to go up for the shot, then try and create and go to the free throw line.
Second personal foul on Fresh, sending Hill to the line.
There you see the Syracuse guards. They got into the lane, and that's one of the things that Dick Bennett wanted his team to try and defend against, even though a lot of shots were missed. Syracuse was successful in the first half in doing that with their guards.
Otis Hill, the freshman from White Plains, drawing the foul and making one of two. 40-26. Gary Gresh, Martinez, and it's blocked by Moten. Moten has just been timing Martinez throughout the game to this point, blocking shots, stealing passes.
Well, the Syracuse guards are very quick, as well as their post players. They're, because of the fact they've got come up with these blocked shots, they look like they're nowhere near the offensive player taking the shot, and all of a sudden Green Bay goes up for it, and then it's taken out of the air. Call it travel. Indecision. Dick Bennett was frustrated with his team in the first half. Indecision. If you're going to take a shot, go ahead and take it. Don't think about it.
That was Vander Velden. Moten at 6'5", the 5-inch advantage over Martinez.
You see Martinez. That's right. Martinez looked like he had enough time, but at 6'5", Moten's able to get over there with his quick feet, too.
Moten feeding Hill inside, and Vander Velden fouls. Syracuse continuing to get men into the lane there. They have created any number of fouls.
Dick Bennett's teams are strictly a man-to-man defense. He does not go into the zone.
Jackson missed everything. Martinez for Gresh. And Gresh hits. Gary Gresh, a sophomore from Wauwatosa, Wisconsin.
Wauwatosa, that's where my mom's from.
All right. You're a desert rat.
I'm a California girl.
Autry's alley-oop try off the mark with a push underneath, and Ludvigsen, somewhat questionable call. The crowd thought so, too.
Well, they thought it was a little late. They tried to front inside, and Ludvigsen getting called for the hole, but good rotation defensively by Green Bay.
Open for Wallace. For the rebound, Ludvigsen came up with it, and this one will be on Moten.
They're going to call a technical on Wallace. Maybe they felt it was a little aggressive. Of course, Ludvigsen just kind of went to the ground, too. And Jim Bayon today, it was a foul over the back. What's the rest of it? But you see Wallace with the miss. Nice rebound by Green Bay. Yeah, Wallace is over the back. Well,
yeah, he kind of slid.
I think a lot of that had to do with what happened in the first half, too.
The personal will be on Wallace, and then the technical attacks onto it. So Nordgaard will shoot the technical.
So he gets two personal fouls now with that technical.
Number 33, Jack Nordgaard, shooting two.
Nordgaard, a 77% free throw shooter.
Points for Nordgaard. That brings it back to a 10-point margin, Syracuse. At 40-30, 16:59 to go, and Boeheim still up doing the number on the officials. Leonard Wirtz from Mount Healthy, Ohio. Andre Patella from Decatur, Georgia. Robert Barnett from Baltimore, Maryland.
This is the Phoenix really have to take advantage of this opportunity.
Martinez, go for him off the back iron.
It almost looked like an indecision shot whether he was going to use the backboard or not, and it comes off the back of the rim.
Autry, a nice move.
Good aggressive play by Adrian Autry coming back down, and yeah, Green Bay was down, but John Martinez, who was guarding Autry, did not get back on defense, and Autry penetrating into the lane again. You see Gresh on him right here, and nice spin move into the middle. He's really good at using that left hand also and drawing the foul.
At the free throw line, Adrian Autry.
Adrian Autry of Syracuse at the line widens the lead to 11 again, 41-30. 7 points for him. The foul on Gary Gresh, his third. Syracuse on top. Lawrence Moten telling his teammates, keep your hands up. Slide into the zone.
A 2-3 zone, they can get to the high post and rotate it quick enough. It's wide open.
And the going outside. Moten with the quick hands again. He has been a pest for Syracuse on defense throughout this game.
Syracuse is really forcing Green Bay to make the passes that they don't want to make. They're telegraphing their passes, just going right around the perimeter. And there's a nice pass inside, because at that time, the pass, normally, in the way this game has been going, back out to the perimeter. That was a nice little fake by Martinez to get it back inside to Nordgaard.
Nordgaard, 15 points now. He had 24, and they win against California. Autry driving, spinning, and hitting. Adrian Autry, the senior from New York City, averages 16-2 a game. And 16 in the victory against Hawaii in the first game. First round action here in Ogden. Vander Velden trying the baseline. He's turned back, and a pushing foul called on Jackson, I believe. We have a timeout with 15:37 remaining in regulation time. Syracuse 44-32.
The 13th ball. Timeout on the floor.
The women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
Mr. Gooden?
That's right.
Any relation to Dwight Gooden?
None at
no.
all.
No, okay. Do you have time for a couple of questions?
Short ones.
Tell us about your HP LaserJet printer.
My LaserJet?
Yeah, what do you think about it?
I don't.
Ever?
Laser jets work. What's there to think about?
But if you did?
I don't.
But if you did?
Well, if I had to think about it, I probably wouldn't have one.
But you do have one.
No, I have two.
Oh.
Is that enough?
Works for me. HP laser jet printers. You do your job, we'll do ours.
Good idea.
The RCA Home Theater with SRS gives you rich, powerful, theater-like sound. With no extra speakers or wires. When there's one in the neighborhood, you'll know it. Now, get up to $100 back on selected RCA home theater televisions.
Trucks are a spiritual thing to me. Something you can depend on. It's just like, you know, my best friend, I guess you might say.
Out on the ranch is where I'm at, and that's where I want the truck to work for me.
I need a truck that's rough like I am.
Introducing the all-new Mazda truck with a 4-liter V6 and a soul to match. The new Mazda truck.
Saddle up and let's go dancing.
Mazda, it just feels right.
A greedy developer targets a historic landmark.
You're a dead man.
Can Jessica keep it from being destroyed?
That's it.
Murder, She Wrote. Then, 3 stars as TV Guide and A Entertainment Weekly.
My dad did unspeakable things to us.
Based on the true story, Ultimate Betrayal, Sunday, parental discretion advised.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Mazda, RCA, and by Hewlett-Packard.
Number 12 seeded Wisconsin Green Bay trailing Syracuse, the number 4 seed in the West, 44-32.
Well, you see opponents' field goal percentage under 50. Green Bay has held opponents, and the top scorer is shooting 81%. But Syracuse shooting 50% in this game right now is coming out of that halftime. But Wake Forest shot the best in that Alaska shootout against the Phoenix at 47%. So they have been number 3 coming into this tournament. The Phoenix holding opponents shooting under 37%.
Syracuse to up with the offense required so far. There's how it stands. And contrarily, Green Bay shooting at only 36%. And there's another miss by Ludvigsen from an open position.
Coming out of that timeout, Jim Gray was over at the Green Bay bench, and Dick Bennett telling his team, saying, quit being so indecisive. We've played teams just as good as these guys. We've got to make decisions and attack. You got nothing to lose. Nice move by Moten.
Moten banks it, beating Martinez. Martinez is going to see Moten in his dreams, I think, this week. 46-32.
Just a smooth move right there by Lawrence Moten. One of the reasons Syracuse can kind of hang back a little bit in this zone is because there's two shooters. One is John Martinez. The other one is Jeff Nordgaard.
Well, Martinez had a little space away from Moten that time. Now has 11. That three-pointer cuts it to 46-35. Missouri team in the background arriving for their game against the University of Wisconsin. That'll be next here from Ogden. And Martinez hits again with a bank shot this time for two. Moten. Moten, who's been Martinez's nightmare. Moten hits for Syracuse. 15 points. Underneath the Vander Velden.
Syracuse substitution, number 44, John Wallace, replacing Lucius Jackson.
Green Bay, I think, would like to, in a sense, penetrate a little bit more into the seams to open up things on the inside, but Syracuse has really packed that zone in because their guards are so quick they can get outside to the perimeter.
Nordgaard.
2-point field goal, number 33.
17 for Jeff Nordgaard. And again, he hesitated a little bit on that shot. He was wide open on the pivot, looked for the pass, and then said, oh, I'm still open, and took the shot.
Perfect alley-oop, hop three to Hill. 9 points for the freshman, Otis Hill.
Contact by the senior Adrian Autry, seeing the little roll by Hill, looking for that because that baseline is wide open.
Vander Velden, yes,
3-3,
need a 40, back to 10. 13-10 remaining second half, and the crowd cheering for the underdog Green Bay Phoenix. Starting to come alive.
If other guys for Green Bay can contribute and hit shots like that, they're going to put it right back in because Syracuse has been keying in on Martinez and Nordgaard. They need other guys to step up.
A steal by Nordgaard, giving Green Bay the ball. Return feed to Nordgaard, and he misses the bank shot. Rebounded by Wallace. Here comes Austin. It'll be Phoenix ball. Wallace took a poke in the eye.
Replacing Scott for Corporal.
You see everybody jockeying for position right there, and We're going to call it Green Bay. Almost looks like it could have been Syracuse, but Wallace gets knocked in the face. Just everybody going for the ball.
Hill gets a rest for Syracuse. That brings Reef Snyder in. J.B. Reef Snyder, a sophomore from Knoxville, Tennessee. Ludvigsen driving the baseline. Made the basket, and he is hurt. Looks like he may have collided, banging his knee as he made the drive. The Syracuse player, 8 points for Ludvigsen. He dropped to the floor after he put the ball up.
It was a wide open baseline. It was one of the first times that the Phoenix had really passed the ball quickly in that zone. They get it to the high post, and once it gets to the high post, they collapse on him. The ball kicks back out to the wing, and Jeremy Ludvigsen does a good job penetrating to the basket. Here you see him swinging down low, and watch the ball come back to the middle. They go up high defensively. Syracuse leaves it open. You can see it. The knees kind of bang a little bit. But Ludvigsen clears out of there. And then the baseline is wide open. See if we get a chance to see where the knees.
Might have been the collision with the floor. I thought at first that it was a collision with the Syracuse player. But I think it may have been after he was out of balance and landed and banged it on the wooden floor. He has a free throw coming as he was fouled in addition to making his basket. And Zavada apparently will take that free throw as he has come in to replace Reef Snyder, but they're still attending to him, as you can see. See there, it doesn't look like, unless it was a twist on the collision, it looks like when he hit the floor.
Well, he hits Reef Snyder going up,
yep.
And you don't know right there whether it got twisted. Like you said, he hits him almost in the calf area, but he lands on it also. So it's just really hard to tell. You do know it's a knee, though.
And there's Zavada, who's coming in to replace Ludvigsen while he goes off with a little attention from the trainers.
That's a tough loss for Dick Bennett's team because Ludvigsen is one of the captains on this team. Really plays hard, his post defense. Trying to keep Wallace and Hill out of there. Really been banging a lot and also taking the offensive mind as far as attacking the basket. So if Zavada can come in and add some offense and play some tough post defense, that will be a big plus.
Reef Snyder picks up the foul for Syracuse and Zavada will take the shot for Ludvigsen. Jeff Zavada, a transfer from Marquette, a senior at 6'9 from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. 50-42, an 8-point lead for Syracuse. 12:04 to go. Autry's pass intercepted. Nordgaard reading that one. 9 turnovers for Syracuse and a turnover right back the other way. Autry driving back into the lane and off for Moten. And Autry charged with the offensive foul.
His third personal foul.
Timeout on the floor, 11:42 to go. 8-point lead for Syracuse.
We're ball players and we're okay. We're not fat and lazy like Devonis say. In spring we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball card. They're ball players, or so they say. They'd rather be doing as for Ben Gay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ain't the deal to hawk underwear.
Your butts to double A, yeah.
Get 2 medium, 2 topping thin crust pizzas, just $12.99. Plus 3 months of Showtime free.
It's a hot deal. It's a cool deal. A Domino's, I want it. I need it, deal.
2 medium, 2 topping thin crust pizzas, just $12.99. Plus 3 months of great entertainment on Showtime free.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
Even with dual airbags, power windows, air conditioning, cruise control, and a powerful six-cylinder engine, the Mazda 626 still costs less than a four-cylinder Camry LE, which may explain the popularity of the 626 among those of us who aren't made of money.
Without knowing, American businesses wasted $1 billion last year by using the wrong long-distance company. $1 billion that could have been reinvested in those businesses. That's why MCI announces $1 billion stimulus plan for American business. Get all the savings from Proof Positive, plus we'll send you a check that doubles your savings every time you get a Proof Positive statement this year. Call and make the most stimulating investment of all, an investment in your business. Clint Eastwood returns in his most famous role, Dirty Harry.
Go ahead.
Sudden Impact.
Make my day.
Contains some violent scenes, Monday.
Well, everybody talks about discipline and offense, but I think being in a stance, constantly adjusting your position to get vision on the ball and man requires more discipline. And we do work at that. We don't just pay it lip service. We work at that because for us, it has to happen every time out.
Well, two defensive sequences right there by Green Bay. You can see the position defense, one by Nordgaard just catching it like a center fielder hanging out there. And then all of a sudden, Gresh hanging back for the charge.
8-point Syracuse lead. Green Bay ball, 11:20 to go in the regulation time. Ludvigsen has not returned to the game as yet. The feed to Vander Velden comes back to him. He misses the shot, but it's fouled. Nordgaard heads up play there. The pass from Martinez to Vanderbilt. And Vanderbilt has had problems handling the ball today, but he got help from his teammate Nordgaard.
John Wallace looks like he comes up with a clean block, but this is what Green Bay has to do. They've got to get the ball inside. They've got to penetrate like that and just take it up against these guys. They're bangers, Green Bay is. They need to start using their bodies and try and creating those fouls.
Vanderbilt at 6'9", the senior from Ballers, Wisconsin, and takes advantage of the foul, hitting the first of two. He can draw them to within six, and they were down by 12. It looked like Syracuse might start to run away from the number 12 seeds, but it is now just a 6-point lead. More than 11 minutes to play.
Well, we'll see if the Phoenix can play some tough defense inside and not let the penetration in the middle. Syracuse really has been doing a pretty good job getting that ball in the lane.
Crowd getting into it in support of the underdog, the number 12 seeded Phoenix from Wisconsin Green Bay. Moten to turn around, backing in beautifully to make that spin move. 52-44, 17 points for Lawrence Moten. Former high school football star from Washington, D.C.
Great block.
Moten got a piece of that. Vander Velden keeps it in there. Now back outside. Intended for Nordgaard. Martinez follows, and Vanderbilt in. The Phoenix rising. 7 points for Vanderbilt. Ludvigsen is back on the bench and about to come in. He suffered the knee injury.
Now Lawrence Moten is the guy that's been making things happen for the Orangemen.
Gresh pushed him out successfully that time. Moten trying to force him in closer to the basket.
That was a forced shot, but Gary Gresh has really been doing a pretty good job on Moten, but Moten is just, he's getting his shot.
Nordgaard, he hit. 52-48, we're down to 4-point Syracuse lead.
Green Bay doing a much better job passing the ball on their offense.
Mercedes-Benz introduces a new car. Other car companies rush to follow. And when Mercedes-Benz introduces a whole class of new cars, others scramble to catch up. Now Mercedes-Benz is introducing the new E-Class, featuring the powerful E420 V8. Other car companies may find this one even harder to follow.
What tire do you trust in the wet? A tire that removes over 2 gallons of water per second from under the tread. The all-season MX4. Another engineering splash from Michelin. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Final call.
We've got to move fast, Kirby. I hope your butt hurts.
Not exactly, but this company's fast.
Fastest hurts number one club goal?
Not exactly, but they do have a special place to pick up the car.
Like Hurts?
Not exactly, but it'll be waiting.
Under a canopy? With the keys in it?
Not exactly.
And protected from the weather?
Not exactly.
In Rent-A-Car, there's Hertz and there's not exactly. Make sure you choose the right one.
Counting on that promotion, Kirby?
No, not exactly.
There's cause for celebration. It's the opening of the latest ITT Sheraton Hotel. Sheraton is now the ultimate global hotel chain for business travelers, with 420 hotels, inns, resorts, and all suites, and one high standard of service in over 60 countries. What does ITT bring to the party? $1 billion worth of improved systems, services, and renovations. ITT, we're adding more than just our name.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Wisconsin Green Bay is off the
cushion. Welcome back to Ogden. I'm Jim Gray. Well, if Wisconsin Green Bay needed a spiritual lift, they may have got it. Jeremy Ludvigsen hurt his right knee. He went down and was attended to in the locker room by Dr. Hinckley. It's just a badly bruised right knee. Dr. Hinckley said if he can tolerate the pain, he can come back and play. And obviously, he can tolerate the pain because he's back in the ballgame. Jim?
All right, Jim. They've cut it to four. They trailed by 16 at one point in this game. Syracuse with the ball. Moten has been the main man, 6 of 13 from the field for Syracuse. They've been trying to get Fresh, their best defender, on him to shut him down.
And John Wallace has been very quiet when he picked up that technical. He went out. It's a double team by Green Bay right here. You see Ludvigsen going in and the little reach down below.
At the free throw line.
Vander Velden picking up the foul, his third for Green Bay. Wallace to the line. Wallace, a key figure in the victory over Hawaii. 24 points, 12 rebounds, and they have yet to get an offensive rebound in this half, and we're almost halfway through. We're a little under, as a matter of fact, with 9:14 showing on the clock now remaining. 13 points for Wallace.
We'll see how the ball movement is for the Phoenix in this possession. Every possession is really important right now for the Phoenix. They cannot afford to trade baskets. They've got to try and play some defense and really square up on their possessions.
Vander Velden trying for three. He missed. Syracuse quickly in the transition, but now Autry slows it up. Trying to penetrate. He does and hits. Adrian Autry, the senior guard. 12 points for him.
Martinez is just really having a tough time moving laterally.
Wearing that knee brace, of course, he missed the first 8 games of the season for Green Bay. And he's not 100%.
You can see the perimeter passing again by the Phoenix. And what hurts Green Bay also, Gary Gresh, who can handle it, but he does not shoot. He doesn't look to score.
Ludvigsen from Martinez back to him. Is there. He's got a shot, but he missed everything off balance. A double pump. Autry back the other way.
Well, he had 4 points in the Cal game, and the two baskets he had, both were at the 35-second clock, right when the buzzer went off.
Autry tripped over Martinez. Here's a freebie for Martinez from Ludvigsen. Five-point Syracuse lead.
Tempo this whole game.
Ball is poked away by Ludvigsen, but it's recovered by Autry. Hill, double team, Vander Velden, nice pickoff.
Ludvigsen got a hand. well. Syracuse just staying back in that zone. Jeremy Ludvigsen just cutting across the key. He felt it was the other way around, but you'll see them go at each other. They've been banging all game long. So whether they call it or not, it's anyone's guess.
5-point Syracuse lead. 6:34 to go. Hill moves from the high post down close to the basket. Wallace Moten deep and just rotating around. Moten starts to drive, pulls up. Ball's out of bounds, off the hands of Moten. Green Bay ball.
Moten just going one-on-one that time. Nobody cleared out, but he didn't look like he was going to pass it to any teammates. The thing is with the Phoenix, they just can't go back and forth and not score on a possession. They've got to take advantage of some of these turnovers by Syracuse.
Martinez pass, poked away by Hill out of bounds.
Tough pass inside because Hill and Wallace have really been patrolling that lane. And Lucius Jackson in the middle, they've done a good job. Syracuse in the baseline.
Dick Bennett takes a timeout for Wisconsin Green Bay. 5-point Syracuse lead, 5:59 to play.
Genuine jockey. Genuine jockey, yeah.
Real quality, real fit. No wonder guys feel comfortable with jockey.
Genuine jockey.
Mercedes-Benz that's technologically innovative, safe, roomy, with exceptional handling is to be expected. But to do it for under $30,000, now that's a feat of engineering. Introducing the Mercedes-Benz C-Class.
For the first time, there's a saw that combines a 12-amp motor, dust collection, and an auto brake. So there's no limit to what you can build. Introducing the Quantum Circular Saw. New from Black & Decker.
New from Pizza Hut, the ultimate pepperoni pizza. With zesty herbs and spices and thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. This is the ultimate pepperoni pizza. But remember, one bite and there's no going back.
20-foot baskets. 300-point games. 100-yard courts. This is the future of the game because an awesome new sports drink is here. Allsport. Unsurpassed taste. A third more carbs than Gatorade for energy. This is a body quencher. After Allsport, the game will never be the same.
Tired of the crime, and when they come after his family,
then he'd kill us both.
He's tired of playing by the rules. Steven Seagal, Marked for Death Tuesday, contains some violent scenes.
All right, folks, Jim Nance, Clark Kellogg's, let's get a quick look at the other games. A great sequence right now. Penn and Florida, and there the Quakers hit another one. The Quakers and Penn with 12, Penn and Florida, that is, with 12:30 to go. And that's a one-point lead there for the Gators, Clark.
Well, they're trying to go inside, but things are heating up. Dan Cross, Craig Brown for Florida, their outstanding backcourt, getting busy. And Jerome Allen, excellent off the dribble. Penn would like to play a little faster pace, but because they're so good in the half court, able to hang right with Florida.
Oh. The jumper. So a three-point lead for the Gators with 12 minutes to go. Meanwhile, Maryland and UMass, this has really turned around, and Maryland is up six with 9 minutes remaining. Clark, what's the story here?
7 of 8 three-point shooting for the Terrapins, and they're playing so well, I'm not sitting down anymore. I've got to walk around in here.
That's a 2 and an 8-point lead. Meanwhile, Green Bay has hit a 3. And let's take it back to Tim Ryan and Ann Myers in Ogden.
Might have bumped knees, maybe bruised in there.
He did, banging knees with Nordgaard, it appeared.
For Syracuse, number 44, John Wallace will be at the free throw line.
Under the 6-minute mark, we go 5:27 to go. Wallace at the line. Boeheim with his starters on the floor. Moten and Autry, the guards. Wallace, Hill, and Jackson up front. A three-point game now. 14 points for Wallace. Wallace, a very good free throw shooter. 76% from the field. He hits them both. 57, 53.
What happens with Ludvigsen hitting some shots inside if they can get it, but also Vanderbilt from the outside. Play a little bit higher on the outside as far as the perimeter is concerned.
Wallace rebounding. A 3-point try from Vanderbilt.
Boards have been a key for Syracuse also. They've kept Green Bay off the boards.
Hill fouled by Ludvigsen. 4 on Ludvigsen now. Jeremy Ludvigsen, the senior from Edgewood, Iowa, in foul trouble with 4. 4:46 to play. The freshman Otis Hill from White Plains, New York, at the line.
At the free throw line, Otis Hill.
Hill shooting a little bit better, 53% from the free throw line. He's the all rookie Big East player.
Gets one of the two. 58-53. 5-point lead. Martinez and Vanderbilt are the 3-point shooters for Green Bay. Gresh outside, primarily a defensive player. And there's the tip by Moten, anticipating again. Gresh after him, and off the foot of Lawrence Moten.
Great hustle by Lawrence Moten. The zone is really being effective for the Orangemen. What they're doing, they're cutting off the pass to the point. What Green Bay has to do, you see Gresh right there going after the basketball with Moten, and it goes off Moten's foot. But Gresh has to step into the free throw line where the elbow is. That's the pass that's wide open. They're hanging out beyond the three-point line, and it's not helping their teammates out because that pass is automatically going back to the point, and Syracuse knows where it's going.
Autry driving the lane. Won't drop for him. Nordgaard rebounds. Gresh slows it down, waiting for help.
Now here's it at the point, and watch the ball go down into the corner. Now Gresh on the weak side has to step up. That's a nice take by Martinez.
For Ludvigsen, and he is fouled. Syracuse thought they had a clean block, but you can hear the slap of hands there.
Well, it's great penetration by John Martinez. A little pump fake, and again, Syracuse likes to go up for the block shots, and Green Bay needs to do that a little bit more. Jim Boeheim saying, oh, look at that, another block.
At the free throw line, number 44, Jeremy.
Otis Hill picks up his second foul. Ludvigsen goes to the free throw line.
Syracuse has been doing a good job sagging back on that zone and clogging up the middle. Green Bay's had a tough time getting the ball inside.
17 foul for Syracuse, a 1-on-1 for Ludvigsen. He gets the first. 4-point lead, Syracuse. Point lead, 3:49 to play. Green Bay 9 of 11 from the free throw line. Syracuse 16 and 20. So both teams have done the job there. Autry trying to penetrate, gets it off for Lucius Jackson. Autry starts it over again. That's on goal, Ludvigsen, and Autry hurt his knee. Adrian Autry in a collision just as he let the ball go. Not a good shot from Adrian, but his coach wanting him to penetrate into that lane where the action is. The big guy's underneath for Syracuse. That time, about the third knee-to-knee collision we've had here in this game so far.
That's why I always wore knee pads. I know guys like don't like to wear them, but it sure saves their knees.
Autry with 12 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 steals. That about says how key he is to this attack and defense.
And he has slipped 2 or 3 times already, and he kind of slips on that shot also. His right foot seemed to go out from underneath him.
Yeah, it didn't really look like a collision on that replay, and it looked like it may have a hyperextension kind of thing. Hard to speculate, but you can see Adrian, a tough guy, is feeling some pain there. So we've had three injuries in this game so far. Ludvigsen was able to come back from his for Green Bay and has been a key player since he returned. Hopefully the same will be true for Adrian Autry, the outstanding senior guard of the Orangemen of Syracuse.
Probably see Lawrence Moten move over to that point position, bringing the ball up. D.B. Reefsnyder will come in.
McCorkle is the choice. He's a forward, a senior from Mission Viejo, California. So they've only got one true guard in there.
Still shooting 50%, which is a big plus for Jim Boeheim's team.
All right, we're underway again. 3:19 to go. A 3-point Syracuse lead, Green Bay ball. For the senior from Edgewood, Iowa. A 1-point game. And the crowd supporting the underdog, number 12, seeded Wisconsin Green Bay Phoenix. Love this action.
I hear you're the competitive type. No, but you might be surprised to find out that the Oldsmobile Cutlass Sierra Special Edition with anti-lock brakes, airbag, air conditioning, and more is over $4,000 less than the Ford Taurus GL. Which leads me to believe, shouldn't their saying be, have you priced a Ford lately? Yeah, about $4,000 worth. It's your money.
This is the award-winning Goodyear Aqua Tread with its deep groove aqua channel. And this is the new Eagle Aqua Tread for performance sedans. A wider performance tire with 2 aqua channels to sweep water away. Now you get the wet traction of a Goodyear Aqua Tread and the performance of a Goodyear Eagle. One good turn deserves another. The new Eagle Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
How we doing?
Dave needs to see you.
I'll be right there. Hey, Ron.
Brad, man, how you doing?
Right.
Brad Johnson has a lot to think about.
Where's my table?
Dave needs in the kitchen right now.
That's why he chose AT&T. Competitive prices without the hassle is his AT&T business advantage.
Hey, Joey, get the big
box. What's up, Dave?
Got problems.
Call a plumber.
So what does Brad think about his long-distance service now? He doesn't.
AT&T works for me.
Let AT&T work for you.
We're ball players and we're okay. We're not fat and lazy like the owners say.
In spring, we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball card. They're ball players, or so they say. They'd rather be doing ads for Ben Gay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ain't the deal to hawk underwear.
We're ball players and we're okay. Get in shape by opening day. Can't
Cubs to double A. Yeah.
Monday on The Late Show, Bill Cosby and singer Sheryl Crow.
On the next day, we reunite Melanie Griffith and Don Johnson.
Welcome back to Ogden, Utah, where it's a one-point game. I'm Jim Gray. Adrian Autry, who left just moments ago with a bruised left knee, is right now has the ball. He's back in the ballgame. He's in quite a bit of pain, but he thinks he's going to be able to play the last 2:43. Tim?
Well, you know he'll stay out there if he can. This is the team leader, the senior, Adrian Autry from New York City. He starts to drive again. Pulls up with a jumper. Still battling for the rebound. Grabbed by Green Bay. Jump ball is signaled. And Syracuse with the arrow.
They called a quick jump ball that time. I think the officials just wanted to make sure that no bodies were really going to start banging into each other because a lot of them went down on the floor. And Ludvigsen getting it, and they called a quick jump ball even though they're trying to call a timeout. I was going to say, obviously, Autry's knee does not hinder him from penetrating to the basket.
Lawrence Moten, watched by Martina, by Greshler, and Nate. 2:16 and counting down. 1 point Syracuse lead.
Just going to clear it for himself, a one-on-one situation.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Jackson. Rebound, Ludvigsen. Green Bay with a chance for the lead. Martinez fakes the three. This is the two. Moten rebounded. 39 to go.
Martinez has struggled from the floor. He's hit three pointers, but when he's penetrated the basket, he's missed some easy shots.
Jackson underneath, foul by Gresh. Four on Gary Gresh, top Green Bay defender, 128.
Syracuse very quick on picking up when the ball goes inside. Green Bay has been rotating their defense there. They were a little slow, but the post players get a bit double teamed, and they're passing it quickly to the weak side.
Ward on top of 10, and upsetting Nebraska in the first round. Jackson, 5 points. Jackson, an 80% free throw shooter.
Played on the 76ers team.
It's the second one, but Syracuse rebounds.
Big rebound by Otis Hill.
1:20 on the clock. 2 points. Syracuse lead. If they get through, Jim Boeheim will be wiping plenty of sweat from the brow against this tough Green Bay, Wisconsin team. We've got 104 to play here. Syracuse leading by two. The number four over number 12. And Adrian Autry makes it 4 points.
The boards have really been a key for Syracuse this whole game and also penetrating in that lane.
Ludvigsen.
Some Autry. Big blocks by Syracuse.
That was Adrian Autry stepping that shot. Green Bay will keep the ball. 47.2 seconds left. 61-57 Syracuse.
Ben Wallace coming into the game. He's a three-point shooter for the Phoenix. Gresh, a defensive specialist, going out.
Ben Wallace, number 34, sophomore guard from Janesville, Wisconsin. He has it. Martinez. Vander Velden. Shoots from outside. So can Martinez. Wallace is the best. He drives. And he's there.
36.9
seconds left.
Good penetration by Berlowski, but watch Hill take the charge. Stands his ground. Smart move by not going up to try and block the shot. Big Bennett happy with the move, but not happy with the call.
So it remains a 4-point lead.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul number 22, Jerry.
And Gresh takes the foul. That'll be five for him. And Gary Gresh will leave the game with five fouls. Berlowski comes right back in to replace Gresh. And it sends Autry to the line, the senior guard. 78% free throw shooter, and of course the most experienced player on the Syracuse team. He misses the first. 30 and a half seconds remaining. A 4-point Syracuse lead. Gets to second. Now it's five. Vander Velden, Autry all over him.
Syracuse on his own, making Green Bay spread things out.
Nordgaard short with a three. Berlowski on the rebound and a foul call on Syracuse.
Syracuse personal foul, number 15, Adrian.
Well, the winner of this game will advance to meet the winner of our second game this afternoon, Missouri and Wisconsin. Missouri, the top seed in the West, taking on Wisconsin, who ousted Cincinnati in round number one. 17.3 seconds left.
Wisconsin Green Bay substitution number 15.
Berlowski at 84% free throw shooter. LeDuc is back in the lineup. Eric LeDuc, a 6'7 senior who picked up two early fouls and hasn't played much since. Maybe one shift. Four-point margin. Three-point margin.
Substitution for Wisconsin.
Jackson comes in for Wisconsin Green Bay.
Replacing Berlowski.
Berlowski goes out. Eric Jackson, a sophomore guard from Milwaukee, number 12. And he immediately fouls Autry. That was Martinez, pardon me, who fouled him. Sending Autry to the line and 16 seconds showing on the clock.
Well, Green Bay going to try and have Syracuse beat them from the free throw line. Autry was one of two the last time he was at the line.
Syracuse 18 of 24 from the free throw line, but Autry misses the first. Glimmer of hope for Green Bay. Takes the second, back to 4 points. Livingston for Berlowski, and there is Moten again for a block. Ludvigsen follows. He can't drop it. Wallace rebounds. Fouled immediately by Berlowski with 5.3 on the clock. Lawrence Moten has been doing that all game long. Anticipating passes, leaping high to block shots. And he earns that smile he has on his face there. Another big play for Lawrence Moten, the junior from Washington, D.C.
Moten with 17 points, only three baskets in the second half, but it's been his defense that has really sparked the Orangemen.
He had 29 points against Hawaii. He's shown the other aspects of his game here as Syracuse will advance and await the winner of Wisconsin, Missouri, next here in Ogden, Utah. 64-59. Lowski, and that is it. The number four-seeded Orangemen of Syracuse had quite a scare from this scrappy, well-coached Wisconsin Green Bay team. The Phoenix couldn't shoot in the first half. It hurt them. And even though they tightened up and played Dick Dennis-style ball in the second, the quicker, more aggressive Syracuse Orangemen proved to be stronger at the end. 64-59, the Syracuse victory. And so Syracuse into the round of 16, and they will meet the winner of Missouri, the top seed in the West, and Wisconsin. That's our next game here in Ogden, Utah. Chevrolet players of the game from Wisconsin Green Bay, Jeff Nordgaard, another strong performance for him. And Lawrence Moten of Syracuse, 17 points, 8 rebounds, 3 steals, 5 of 6 from the free throw line, an all-around fine game. And now from Ogden, Utah, let's go to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, Timmy, no Cinderella in the Sweet 16 yet. But let's go to Long Island. Penn and Florida, final 4 minutes and change. Here's James Brown, Billy Packer with Penn against Florida.
A rough afternoon for Matt Maloney of Pennsylvania as the Quakers trail by five to the third seed of Florida Gators. Matt Maloney, the outstanding guard for Pennsylvania, 1 of 12 from three-point range, only 7, and he's the team's leading scorer at 14. From here at the Nassau Coliseum, Connecticut advanced earlier, beating George Washington, which got an impressive performance from Yinka Darre. Pennsylvania and Florida fighting for the right to move on to the round of 16 from this half of the East bracket.
Well, as we wind on down.